Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya speaking to reporters at Sisalan.
Hintayin nyo na lang. It will happen.
Sir, kanina sa NDT you mentioned na yung tungkol po dun sa mga reklamo sa kanya ng illegal possession. Pwede na po bang basihan yun tungkol dun sa pagde-designate sa kanya as terrorist at bakit?
Actually, if you read the law, it's very clear.
Sir, for the benefit po ng mga...
You have to read the law. It's very hard to explain it now. Baka pawisan ako pag in-explain ko, mainit eh.
Pero sir, para sa viewers lang sir, para lang medyo may idea.
Ano yan eh, yung nagpapapatay, yung nagre-recruit ng taong pumatay, yung mga gumagastos sa pera para magpapatay, yung bumibili ng mga barel para magpapatay, yung ang tao yung natatakot na sa nangyayari, ang pananakot na nangyayari, ang takot na isipan ng tao sa isang lugar. Yan, mga bagay yan na naroon sa anti-terror law.
Sir, mayroon lang politically yung may NBI director sa kung ano kung gagawin natin
doon? I have to talk to him, to Mr. Oliva. I have to know. I will ask him to make a sworn statement so we can make it part of the case. Kasi ano yan eh, it's part of the profile that will be established in the Anti-Terror Council when we start designating him, when we ask the NBI itself will be the one recommending actually his designation.
Meron din siyang binanggit na isa pa Assistant Regional Director ng NBI, si Noel Bukaling.
He went to me to explain. It's okay. Wala, sir, wala problema.
Sir, ano information mo doon sa naging day-day sa Senate hearing sa big office? Medyo
naka- well, I think that it establishes the pattern of terrorism that happened in Negros. Yung tatlong araw sa Senado, marami naman lumabas na mga nang pangyayari, na mga taong takot na takot, mga taong pinapapatay na sinasabi nila sino pumatay, kung paano ginawa, ang involvement ng police na parang naging baluktot na doon sa Negros dahil sa mga sa impluensya ng mga politiko. I think that the Senate meeting reveals a lot of things about this. Meron siguro ibang mga taong kausap. Dadaan lang ako doon para mga musta. Ang sabi sa akin, kung pwede dumaan lang ako.
Sir, yung mga cases, yung mga reklamo laban po kay Tevez, kailan, Congressman Tevez, kailan po ba natin, sir, nakikita na ipapile?
Hindi ko talaga alam. Depende talaga sa panel of prosecutors. I cannot micromanage that. And I do not intend to micromanage it. Ganun talaga, due process yan. Hintayin natin, matagal talaga. Gano'ng katagal ba bago na demanda si ano, si DJ Bantag? Hindi ba matagal din? Ganun talaga ang due process. Huwag kayo maiinip. Yung trabahong ito talagang tsaga ang kinakailangan.
Sir, anong reaction po ninyo na ang sinasabi ni Tevez na una ang panghuhusga kasi sa pagsasalita
ng kaso? No comment. I don't have to say anything. I don't have to dignify statements. Pumarap siya sa proper forum. I don't have to answer him. No comment. Yung takot humarap, may kasalanan yon. Kaya humarap na lang siya kung wala talaga siyang kasalanan.
Sir, sa latest monitoring, nasa po rin yung
parang nandulong pa. Pero babalik ng Cambodia. I think he will go back to Cambodia.
Sir, meron bang hope from the DOJ or DFA regarding sa passport po ni Congressman
Dennis? Ano yan? It comes with the progress of the cases. Hindi natin pwedeng himay-himayin yan na hiwa-hiwalay, magkakasama lahat yan. It all follows as a matter of course.
Sir, bakit sa tingin yung babalik sa Cambodia sa Dennis?
Para may comfort zone siya ron eh. We learned a few things about it.
Sir, bakit po comfort
zone? I don't know. I was just told.
Tuloy-tuloy po yung monitoring ng data?
I think so, yeah. Tuloy-tuloy.
An extradition date ba tayo sa
Cambodia? Wala. Pero ano yun eh? I do not see that as a significant after we are able to file terrorism charges.
De Lima, pwede na po ba tayo mag-dibang?
Yes, please.
Yun nga po, yung kay Senator De Lima, I understand, pinare-reopen po, nire-request.
Hindi, ganito yan, no? When the talk of bail about Senator De Lima was made, after Attorney G.G. Reyes was granted bail by the Supreme Court. I was very agreeable, and I'm still agreeable to granting bail to based on the habeas corpus petition, which says that the 6-year period of trial may be too long, that the 6-year period of detention by undergoing trial may be too long, and that it may deserve a better turn if she's granted bail on humanitarian grounds. Now, what happened was, her counsels decided to take advantage of our softness on this issue by saying they will file a petition for bail based on lack of evidence, which is very far from the reason why we do not oppose bail. So the fact that we want her to have bail is based on humanitarian grounds, not on the merits of the cases. So if they insist on making the merits of the cases the ground for bail, then I guess we will have to object to it. It is really our intention to grant her bail based on humanitarian grounds, not on the merits or demerits of the cases. Kaya ayan ang nagiging problema natin ngayon. And then, well, I just asked some prosecutors and some of the senior ones about the motion to reopen the case to submit more evidence. It's because of the fact that after the recantation of Ragos, the prosecution was ready to come up to present its rebuttal evidence, because that is allowed by the law and by procedure and by the courts usually. But the court decided to terminate the proceedings and submit it for decision. And it is the feeling of the prosecution, not me, no, but the panel, that they wanted to present rebuttal evidence on the recantation of Mr. Ragos. So make it clear, no? Bail as a matter of humanitarian ground, no? As a humanitarian gesture, is what we support here in the DOJ, not on the merits or demerits of the cases. Because 6 years is a long time to be detained while undergoing trial. I think it's very clear that we want to give her a fair shake, no matter what. And maybe a respite from detention. But her lawyers think otherwise. I think that that they should take advantage of this opportunity to say she's innocent, and that was why she should be granted bail. So, malayo ho yan. It's two big things far apart from each other. The softness on granting of bail based on humanitarian grounds, I think, should not be underemphasized. We still support bail based on humanitarian grounds, not on the merits or demerits of the cases.
Sir, so magpa-file sila ulit based on the...
On the same habeas corpus ground of that was used by the Supreme Court in the decision of Attorney Jessica Reyes. I think that it could have an analogous effect on her case. She's been Attorney Reyes was 9 years or a little more than 8 years in detention by undergoing trial. She has marked her 6th year in detention. That's why the humanitarian ground is very much in our mind to allow her bail, not on the merits or demerits of the cases. That's what I told them also, that we would not oppose bail based on humanitarian grounds. I think we were very clear about that. But they want to make a political spectacle out of it. Her lawyers want to make it to convert it into something else, which is not fair in terms of fighting the case properly. When you try to petition for bail based on the weakness of the evidence, then that is your risk. That is the risk you have to take. But I said, if it's on humanitarian grounds, we will not oppose it.
Sir, may na-mention kayo na parang back-channel to timeline?
Yes, we wanted... actually, we were offering even hospital arrest or to soften up everything. We were offering a lot of concessions just for as a humanitarian gesture to her, because after all, she was a senator of the Republic and a Secretary of Justice.
Anong nangyari, sir?
Well, I don't know. They did not respond to our opportunities, to our gesture.
Pero it stands pa rin, sir?
It stands. It stands. Based on humanitarian grounds, we will give her, we will not oppose bail. Basta wag natin pag-usapan ang merits or demerits of the cases. Malaking pagkakaiba na, no? It's a big difference. Let me say this, no? He spoke to my colleague, one of my colleagues in the cabinet, to say that he may wish to surrender. That's why we are not pushing for law enforcement to hurry up the process. But of course, it is the job of law enforcement still to enforce the warrant of arrest. Same thing.
Sir, meron bang kaakibat na kondisyon yung wish to surrender?
Wala naman eh. I was just told by a colleague that he received a call from him asking if surrender was possible. And of course, I said yes.
Kailan to, sir?
A few days ago, mga 6 days ago.
At how possible yun, sir, na...
Or 5 days ago.
Talagang mangyayari itong...
Well, we'll wait again. I will talk to my colleague again. I will ask him if that offer was followed up by another gesture. I think so. Andito pa siya. Wag muna natin mag-usapan ngayon kasi I told my colleague that I will hold his identity in confidence.
Sir, clarify ko lang si Sulweta.
I don't know. It's Bantag only who called up. I don't know about Sulweta.
Sir, bakit daw gusto niyang sumurender na? Kasi sinasabi niya dati,
I don't know. Alam mo, mahirap magtago. Mahirap magtago sa batas. It should be very difficult. I would say it's difficult. Hindi madali mag-wanted. Okay? Automatic yun eh. Pag may warrant of arrest ka na, automatic na yun. Okay, salamat ha.
Sir, Tebe, sir, blue notice.
Hindi ko na pinapansin yan eh. I'm after the designation and prescription. Designation first, prescription later. And if you read the law, there are very interesting facets of the anti-terror law, which you will find out. And you can ask better questions if you read the law. So I suggest that you can understand it naman as layman. Hindi naman kayo mahirapan intindihin yan. Mag-uumpisa na. We started already. I had a meeting this morning about it. And a meeting again this afternoon about it. I asked some of my colleagues about it. Some members of the Anti-Terror Council.
Two officials daw po, sir, while
the wala yan. I will not even dignify his statements. Di ba? I will not dignify any of his statements. Ano yan eh?
That was Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya. Now, earlier in the press conference, he was talking about Congressman Arnolfo Teves. He detailed some of the circumstances and how a person can be tagged as a terrorist. This is in line, of course, with the agency's plans of having Teves tagged as a terrorist in his alleged involvement in the killing of Governor Ruel Degamo. Rimulya asks for patience from the public regarding the possible filing of charges against the alleged mastermind in the murder. He adds, this is all part of due process. On the issue on the case of former Senator Laila De Lima, he said, when there was talk of bail, he said he was agreeable with it for humanitarian grounds for the former senator, given her long incarceration while the case or her cases are ongoing. But Rimulya says her counsel took advantage of that statement by asking for a petition for bail, but for lack of evidence. He says he disagrees with the manner of asking for the petition based on the merits of the case. Rimulya, meantime, revealed that they have offered concessions to De Lima, even offering a hospital arrest for the former senator, given her situation, but her camp has yet to respond to that. The Justice Secretary also touching on the case of former prison chief Gerald Bantag. He revealed that Bantag has talked to a colleague of his, or a colleague of Secretary Rimulya, about the possibility of surrender. No word, however, on his former deputy, Ricardo Zulueta. Both have warrants out for the killing of broadcaster June Villamor and an inmate.